Good afternoon. It's Friday the 7th of April 2017. A warm welcome along on this beautiful day to United Kingdom Talk. I've been very busy already today. I've been out, done bits and pieces. Oh, yes. After, of course, the excitement of Barry Manilow yesterday. Oh, now, just a little point before we start today. Those of you that have been watching the show on Periscope, and it's just so few of you, it's not worth the effort going on Periscope. So this will be the last show that we do on Periscope as well, and then we just move the whole thing onto Facebook Live. Okay, so if you're not on my Facebook, you can become a friend or just a follower, then you'll get the little notifications whenever we do a show on Facebook Live. My username on Facebook Live is Chris Reardon UK. There it is again. I think, hang on a minute, no, is that it there? I think it's on number three. Is it on number three? No, not there. Is it there? There he is. Facebook.com, Chris Reardon UK, right? That's where you'll find me on Facebook. Facebook.com/ Chris Reardon UK is the number. So last time on Periscope, move the whole thing across to Facebook. Facebook Live, Facebook.com/ Chris Reardon UK is my bits and pieces there. So that was it. All the excitement of Barry Manilow last night. The world was in meltdown, wasn't it? Did you see the trending? It was all Barry Manilow. How fantastic. And there he is. My signed, Barry Manilow has touched that. Look, Barry, would you like to see a little bit closer? You can't quite see that over there, can you? I don't think, can you see? Yes, you can. I won't move it because I'll never get it back up again. All this stuff is held up by nails. Okay, nails in a plasterboard wall. And honestly, anything could come tumbling down at any moment, including the Mirable, which happened a few Christmases ago. Do you remember that? The Mirable actually fell down and I nearly died on this programme. No one cares. Look, no one cares. No one cares. You would like me to die on here, wouldn't you? It would be the Tommy Cooper moment, boys and girls, except not on the London Palladium stage. Instead, in this purpose-built television complex known as the United Kingdom Talk Studios. Barry Manilow has actually touched that. So exciting yesterday. Barry Manilow. Oh, yes. You wait till the next lot of concerts, especially the Manilow people that are watching this programme as well. Good evening to the... good morning, afternoon or evening to the Manilow girls. Next time there's a concert here, you better get those tickets quick. Of course, being a member of the Barry Manilow International Fan Club, we do get the tickets before the general public, boys and girls. The general public. You get the tickets after from the dreadful places such as Ticketmaster.com, or you'll be hanging around outside the O2, you know, with tickets with ticket tout. You want to buy any tickets, mate? You want to buy any tickets? Yeah. Two tickets here. £2,000 each. You wait till the next lot of concerts here. They'll be pouring in people, because there are young people, I suppose, that don't actually know who Barry is. And as I've said so many hundreds of millions of times before, you have not... get down, will you? That can't get my microphone in the right position today. You have not been to a concert until you've been to a Barry Manilow concert. There are very, very few people on the same sort of level as him. Shirley Bassey, probably on the same level as Barry Manilow. Neil Diamond, no, not quite. Neil Diamond, fantastic, nothing wrong. Not quite on the same level as Barry Manilow. You know, Beyonce, don't make me laugh. Spice Girls. The Spice Girls on the same level as Barry Manilow. Are you having some sort of joke? No, I don't think so. No Spice Girls, dear. Bon Jovi? Yeah, but in a different way. They're probably at the same level as Barry Manilow, aren't they? Bon Jovi, someone like that. But you haven't been to a concert till you've been to a Barry Manilow concert. Next time you get a chance to go, then please, please go. You will not be disappointed. The atmosphere is absolutely electric before he comes on. And I hope the Manilow girls won't mind me telling you this, but I save the money and I get the front row seat. Costs a lot of money, but worth every single penny. And I've sat in that front row, and I don't mind, I'm sure the girls won't mind me telling you this, listening to conversations going on around me. And they literally, I remember one lady, she says, she had to keep going to the toilet. She was so excited. I'm like that as well. I just carry a bottle next to me. They don't notice, you see. These ladies sitting in the front row, they don't notice. Sometimes, you know, if I want to go and have a wee when Barry Manilow's on, I just get the bottle out. They're so watching the stage, no one notices, and I just put it under the chair. I do take it back with me. Don't be saying I leave things like that everywhere. No, I highly recommend, if you go to a Barry Manilow concert, take with you, if you're a man, a little bottle. If you're a lady, a bedpan. Bedpans need to be taken to Barry Manilow concerts because you don't want to miss anything. You don't know what's going to happen next. Huh? There you are. So good luck to him. So that was yesterday. We talked about Barry Manilow. Last night, I was off last night. I've got three Thursdays off in a row. Last night, they have what is it called now? American, oh God, I can't remember what it is. They have the American drag queens come over. And the bloke that looks after him doesn't like me, so he's asked for another DJ on those Thursdays. Oh, no reason to lie, which I'm quite pleased about that. I didn't like him either. Oh, God, so talk about the cock of the ball. Do you know what I mean? Walks around one of those alpha males. I can't bear him. So I was off last night. Next week I'm off because it's Maundy Thursday. So I want to go to church next Thursday, and the week after, I'm at my sister's. So I've got the next three Thursdays off, the next two Thursdays off. One's already gone. So last night I did my accounts, because my accounts year, my inland, what do you call it? My tax year runs from April to March. So I just come to the end of my tax year a couple of weeks ago. And I have to put all my accounts together. Now, generally, throughout the year, as I get a receipt, I'm self-employed, OK? So when I get a receipt, I get the receipt, maybe petrol, £53, OK? So I open up my money programme, petrol, £53, OK? And then on the other side, I put my income. So Wednesday night quiz, £100, and put that in like that. And I do that throughout the year. And every single thing that you spend out or get in, you must write down. And that's how it all works. And then at the end of the year, I send all my papers off to my lovely accountant who puts everything together. So I do try and keep on top of it. But at the end of the year, I then go through certain things that I pay every month. For example, council tax. Every month I pay, I think last year it was £80 a month. So 80, that's what it is out here. That there are people in London watching and listening to this show at the moment. So £80 a year, £80 a month. £80 a month, because they're paying like £150, £160 a month in London. So what it is, number one, I don't live in London, okay? And number two, I live on my own. So I get, I think it's either a 25 or a 30% discount, I think, because I live on my own. So it works out to about £80 a month. That's what my council tax was last year. This year it's £83 a month. So it's gone up just a tiny little bit like that. Okay, just about 75 pence a week or something ridiculous like that. So I go through those and I see January, February, March, and it might go June. I'm like, oh, I've missed a couple out. Then I put them in. And I do the same with my regular outgoings. I've got three mobile telephone contract thing, that's £30 a month. I've got my Virgin Media broadband, which is round about £45 a month. It's quite dear, the broadband. I get a bit of phone use for that as well, but nothing to write home about. So it's about £45 a month. I could get a much cheaper broadband from BT, but I wouldn't get a 200 meg one. You know, I've got 200 meg coming down, and I think about 12 meg going up. So very, very fast. And that's what I need while I'm doing my little video shows and things like that. So again, I go through that, you know, January, February, March. Always one miss in there. Then I go back and look at the Virgin Media bills, you see. So there's that one. What else have I got? Spotify, £4.99 a month. Again, I go through every month, make sure it's written there. Because if I don't write down, say, for example, I miss out Virgin Media broadband for September, right? And it's like £45. Well, that's another £45 I've got to pay the tax man. And my mum would say, why should they have it? Absolutely. Why should they have it? So you must make sure that everything is written down there. A few other bits and pieces. And I started doing that last night at about 8:30. And I think I finished at about 12:30. But it's done. It's done. And all my... Do you want to see? Look. I can't show you, can I? Okay, I can show you this, but for example, oh, let's get that here. As well as my stacks of the long list of stuff that I've written down, I also have to send out bank statements. As you know, I do a bit with property as well. I have to send off my mortgage statements. So the accountant then works out how much interest is claimable back, and all my receipts. I keep in little envelopes like this. So these are April's receipts. Okay, but that's all to do with kind of Chris Reardon discos. That's DJing, karaoke, quiz nights. They're all my receipts, and each month has its own little envelope. And there's a pile down there on the floor of all this stuff. I'm just waiting for a few more mortgage statements to come because there's three or four still missing. So they come over the next few weeks, and then I send everything off to my accountant, who then opens it all up, puts it all together, tells me what's missing. And then I try and find the things. Well, I always do. I find the things that are missing and I send them off to him. And then he does something with it and then emails me this inland revenue tax form thing. And I sign it and I send that back. And then he sends it back and tells me how much I've got to pay to the tax man in January. Now, I don't have to do these. Right? This doesn't have to be done until the end of December. OK, I think it's the 31st of December, but I like to send it all off to the accountant. And then in a couple of weeks time, he'll be able to tell me once I've sent it off, 2 weeks after that, he'll tell me exactly how much I've got to pay the tax man in January. I already know what I've got to pay him in July. So July and January, I pay him. He tells me how much I've got to pay in December, and then I'm all ready for it. And it's fantastic. And I don't understand why other people don't do it like this. You know, they leave it till the last minute. I mean, how stupid can you be? Yeah, so you put your accounts in, send it to your accountant, and, you know, I don't know, a week before December the 31st, the accountant then tells you, oh, you've got to send £8,000 to the tax man. Oh, well, where have I got that from? Well, if you hadn't have spent so long putting your stuff together, then you'd all be sorted, wouldn't you? You've got to get on top of your money. You've got to keep an eye on your money, otherwise you get in a terrible state. Then you have to take a loan out, because the tax man don't wait. He's not going to wait for his £8,000, mate. No, he wants it now. None of this paying weekly business. Oh, no. He wants it now. So you have to take a loan out. You'd have to take a loan out for £8,000, which you might, oh, it's only a loan. Yeah, then you've got to pay interest on that. Why are you paying interest? You didn't have to do that. And the amount of stupidity some people... And then they're late putting it in. Immediate £100 fine. Bang. So you've just sent a £100 fine because you couldn't get it together. How stupid can you be? But there's a lot of people can't deal with their money. You know, got these credit card bills of, oh my God, thousands of pounds. You see them on the telly, don't you? Programmes... I don't know what sort of program, like Can't Pay, Well, Take It Away, you know, credit card bills of 10, 20, 30,000 pounds. How do you, see, to me, that is completely alien. How on earth do you build up a credit card bill of 30,000 pounds? I mean, the person concerned, if you've got one yourself, then I don't blame you completely for it, partly for it. Yeah, absolutely. I don't know how you can get yourself into such a state like that. But some people, it's not all your fault. I know that. The banks are so easy to give it away. Oh, you go to the, you know, can I have a £2,000 loan? Yeah, of course you can. It's £2,000. Why don't you have four? Go and have 4,000. It all comes across as a little bit like that. And you got to keep on top of your money. You absolutely have, or you get into a terrible, terrible state. Very important. First thing to pay. First thing to pay on your bills, the rent or mortgage. First thing to pay, rent or mortgage. Very, very important. Do not ever fall behind with your rent. It's so easy to get you kicked out. It really is. That's the most important thing. Pay your rent and your mortgage first. Very, very important. Anyway, so I did my accounts last night. And then I had a bit of a clear out. I got a filing cabinet of all bits of paper, and I went through that, chucking stuff out. You know, driving car insurance that's like 10 years old. I'm finding bits of paper with all this stuff on it, guarantees that run out decades ago. Well, not decades ago, but years ago. I found guarantees from 2002. 1 year guarantee from. I chucked an awful lot of paper out and old stuff in here last night. I've got a good sneeze here. Oh, no. I've got no tissues. Oh, dear. Excuse me. They never sneeze on the news, do they? Have you noticed that? Good old Moira Stewart nearly never used to sneeze on the news, did she? Or that other bloke who's always trying to tell unfunny jokes. Simon on News 24. You know Simon? The one that he's a nice bloke, but he's a bit... I think he's a bit laid-back, old Simon, on the BBC News Channel, isn't he? So got rid of loads of paper. And as I say, waiting for some bank statements, and that's it. That's what I did last night. And then I went to bed. I had spaghetti bolognese. I've got a story to tell you about that. I had a bit of a disaster in the kitchen on Tuesday night. I'll tell you about that in a minute. Let's go to some of your messages this morning. Good morning to Gustav, who says, morning, lovey, let's see that jacket. Ah, no new jacket, Gustav. I'll come to that in a minute, lovey. No new jacket. I'll come to it in a minute. Good morning to the lovely Anne Taplin. Dino's with us this morning. Morning, Dino. Sean Michael Crabtree is with us. Good morning, Chris. What a lovely day it is. Washing is hanging out today. Yeah, mine too. Mine too. I actually did my washing yesterday and I left it hanging out all night. I've got to say, Sean, the garden is disastrously dry at the moment and there's no rain forecast. I can't remember the last time it rained. So I think what I'm sorry about that noise. Can you hear that? Oh, it's that. There's some bloke over there. I don't know if he's got a workshop, but he's got this blasted thing that whirs around cutting up metal or bits of wood or something like that. Gets on my bleeding nerves, that does. Spoiling my... if he does it again, I'll close the window. I've got the window closed at the moment. Yeah, we've not had much rain at all here, Sean. I'm going to have to get the hose out, I think, and give the garden a good water. I bought... Ronnie bought me a little plant this week. Clematis climbing thing. And I bought two blue Himalayan poppies, which were only very small plants at the moment. Anyway, I put those in this morning, actually, just before I left to go down to the shops. And digging it, I thought, my God, that's really dry, that. So I'm going to have to give that a good water. Good morning to Tanya Sheridan. Afternoon, Tanya. Rod says, good morning, Chris. I've had to turn the phone up louder as I'm taking a shower. Oh, are you naked while you're watching this show? Did you want me to get naked with you as well? Just a suggestion. Good morning to the lovely Carl Rex Morrison. Good afternoon to you, sir. Afternoon, morning, it's all the same, isn't it? Josh is with us in... Sartiano. Where's that, Josh? Oh, you're on holiday at the moment, aren't you? Is that Sartiano? That sounds a bit Brazilian. I'm not quite sure where you've gone now. I know you did tell me before. Where are you, Josh? Are you watching on a beach somewhere in a small pair of shorts, are you? Hello to Kim Witt. Did you get your new jacket? Oh, coming to that in a minute, Kim. Coming to that in a minute. Sean says, Cliff Richard's good at concert. Yeah, I should imagine he is. My friend Keith George has actually met Cliff Richard a few weeks ago. How fantastic to meet your hero like that, isn't it? It really is. One of my heroes is Sue Ellen, Linda Gray from Dallas. And I met her a couple of years ago outside her theatre. I had a little bit of a chat with her. Did you see the video? I have got a 20-second chat with myself and Linda Gray on video somewhere. If you want a link to that, send me a private message and I'll link it up for you. Okay, Tweety says many people spend more than they can afford. Yes, they do. Good morning, Adam as well. Adam's with us as well today. Lots of people asking about the new jacket, boys and girls. Where is the new jacket? Well, so this morning. I had my breakfast and I thought, oh, shall I do my show first? And I thought, no, I'll go to town first. So I went to town. First of all, I went to the bank. I've oiled my bike chain at last. Yes, it was looking rather rusty. I used to be really, really strong about oiling bike chains. But weirdly, I found that the more you oiled them, the quicker they seem to wear out. Anyone else find that? You know that thing with the cogs? What's that called? The sprocket or something like that, I think it's called. Is that what it is? I don't know. But they kept wearing out. So I've stopped oiling it and it seems to last for ages now. But it was that the chain had gone kind of a bit rusty. So I oiled that this morning with my spray. I got spray oil. Did that, and I went down to the bank. Then I went to the post office to dropping some of my brother cartridge things. Here they are. There's one over here. Hang on a minute. These things. These brother, you know, cartridge for my printer. Well, I do all my printing for karaoke slips. Oh, I had to print. I printed a load of those last night. Karaoke request slips last night. So I took that bit in for recycling. You just drop it in the post office. You don't have to queue up. Post office is in WH Smiths. From there, I went into Bentalls to have a look at that jacket, boys and girls. And I picked it up. I picked up the size 6, and it was kind of hanging down like that. To be honest, it was a bit thicker than I thought it was. Might be a bit too much for the summer. And then, blow me down, I found a similar one, but in cotton linen. And it was the same price, but it didn't have, of course, it didn't have the lining that the one I liked had. So I'm umming around in a bit now. Also, the 20% discount from Ted Baker wasn't in Bentalls. So that would be online. So I tried the 6 on, and I know I'm a size 5 Ted Baker, which is, I think it's extra large, okay? So I tried the 6 on, that was too big. Tried the 4 on, that was too small. Guess what? No size 5. So I didn't buy it. And I've got back on my bike, and I went down to Waitrose, got a few bits and pieces in Waitrose. I didn't get a chance to have a cup of coffee. I usually stop in there, in the cafe. It's really busy in there this morning. They're all in there for their free tea, aren't they? God, dear. And while I'm walking away in Waitrose, pushing my little trolley, I thought, you know, do I really want that jacket? Because I've got a bit of a plan. I've got a plan for the next year. I've got a plan. And so everything that goes out will take maybe a little chip out of that plan and might stop me getting there. I had a plan for last year, but I didn't quite get there. So this year I've got a plan as well. And I'm actually further on in the plan than I need to be at this point. So I think I won't buy it. I'm not sure. Still might happen. But this linen one that was standing in Bentalls was lovely. And the thing is with linen, it creases so easily. And the look, I've got another one here. Just a minute. Let me show you this. Look. Now, here is my other linen one. Now, as you can see, it's really creased up. And like this bit here is, it won't stay out. Can you see what I mean? It kind of bends in. And it's really creased up. Now, this bothers me. Okay, I did take it down to Mrs. Patel. She does all the, let me hang that up there, isn't it? She does, oh, hang on, I can't hang that up there. Where can I put this? I'll put it over there for now. One minute. Mrs. Patel down the road, she does all the dry cleaning and that. And I said, can you try and press that? Well, she did. To be honest, it didn't look much different to me. So how do you get that so it's straight again and uncreased? Or is it okay? My mate Ron, he says that's okay, you know, because that's how people wear them. Carl, don't you work in a clothes place, Carl? How do I get the creases out of my linen jacket, dear? I need to know these things. How do you get the creases out of a linen jacket? Anyone know the answer to that? Dear me. So that's it, really. So I didn't get the jacket. All right, didn't happen. The town centre, as you know, in Bracknell, is being rebuilt at the moment, and that's moving along so quick now. They've now got all this, and it's so different. There's a hell of a lot of shops moving into Bracknell. They've got the side panels on the brand new shops. It's just like a complete building site at the moment, the town centre. So coming along very, very quickly. And that's it. That is my day so far. And no jacket, I'm afraid. No jacket. What a shame. Now, bit of a disaster in the kitchen on Tuesday. But I'll tell you about that in a minute. We've got a couple of stories to do here, boys and girls. Coca-Cola Helium. In the newspapers, Coca-Cola Helium. All the taste of Coca-Cola, all the fun, of inhaling a helium balloon and speaking with a squeaky voice. You're going to love this. You will love this. Look at it. Helium Coca-Cola. See that? Bicarbonating Coca-Cola Classic with a small shot of helium, they say, the drink alters the vocal cords by allowing sound to travel faster, and it makes them more responsive to high-frequency sounds. This creates the squeaky, high-pitched effect on the drinker's voice. Coke spokeswoman Kate Miller says, "We're delighted to be launching Coca-Cola Helium this year. It really inflates our range of drinks and lifts our fans' spirits. Popularity of Coca-Cola continues to balloon, and this new variant is set to be a flyaway success." So do you think that's something that you would like, boys and girls? Coca-Cola Helium. Would you try something like that? After the old Coca-Cola, you know, usually, and then you start burping, don't you? With this one, with Coca-Cola Helium, you'll be able to make funny voices. Would you try that? Call in and let me know. Phone lines are now open only for a short period of time. We've got the phone lines open today, boys and girls. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number if you fancy a little bit of a chat this morning, OK? 020, or this afternoon, 020-8144-3477. There's a Skype in as well if you're somewhere else in the world. And you have Skype, you can Skype in. Our Skype name is United Kingdom Talk. All one word, United Kingdom Talk. Thank you, those of you that have shared the programme on your wall as well. I noticed that. Very kind of you to do so, OK? So that's Coca-Cola Helium coming up there, boys and girls. You might want to try that now. Shock horror. Shock horror in today's Daily Mail. Blind Date is coming back. And Paul O'Grady is hosting it. Excellent choice. What an excellent choice, I have to say. Look at this. As Cilla Black's best friend in the Daily Mail this morning, Paul O'Grady was the obvious choice to take the reins of the beloved show Blind Date when it returns to the screen this year. Da-da. I wonder if it'd be the same theme song. Da-da, 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 ba-da. Da-da. Would it be the same theme too? Anyway, and Paul O'Grady didn't hold back as he took over his hosting duties, shocking audiences with his potty mouth and quipping that the late icon, who died in August, took drugs in 2015. Did you know that? Cilla Black, according to Paul O'Grady, at the warm-up, took drugs. Potty mouth? Yeah, well, he has, yeah. But it's all comedy. It's comedy. I saw Paul O'Grady before he became big at a place called the Dog and Fox in Wimbledon. That would be 1987, 1988 maybe. And he used to do his Lily Savage there, and it was rude. I mean, really rude. Really rude. So that is him, you know. But you don't see that on the telly. That's the bit he does in between the programmes. The story goes, as he struggled to find his feet filming the second episode of it's going to be on Channel 5's on Wednesday, the comedian went on to jokingly blame Cilla's spirit for the blunders, so it was all gone a bit wrong. According to The Sun, the talk show host forgot the contestants' names and swore, leading him to quip, "How the f*** did Cilla do this for 25 years? No wonder she was on cocaine, God bless her, wherever she is." Paul is said to also have shouted at producers for playing music over him as he attempted to speak, and quipped the only reason he was doing the show was that Cilla had left him the programme in his will. He went on to label his best friend as mad and recalled a time she accidentally split his nose open on holiday. Paul and Cilla met on the chat show Parkinson in 1998. They immediately struck an unbreakable bond because of their Scouse roots. Cilla, of course, died 72 years old, which was when she fell over. I'm sure you remember when she fell over, Cilla. Poor Cilla. But there we are. Paul says, "I'm honoured to present the brand new series. And after speaking to Channel 5, I know the series is in safe hands. So good luck. Good luck. And I hope he makes a good thing on that. You know, but do you think Cilla was on drugs? I find that hard to believe, to be honest. could Cillian have been on drugs? I don't know. I don't think so. I don't know. It, was he just saying that as a comedy type thing, do you think? But we love Cilla. Whatever, but you know, often I say, whatever people do in their own time, does that affect me watching them on the telly? I don't think so, not really. Not really, does it? Doesn't. Hello to Kelly Kim, our wonderful teacher lady who's on holiday at the moment, aren't you, Kelly Kim? Greetings and welcome to the show, Kelly Kim. Anne says, I would try it, be a laugh. Stop it, Anne. Stop it, Anne. Oh dear. Carl doesn't know how I'm going to get the creases out of my linen jacket. Oh, maybe I might do a YouTube on that. We might do a YouTube on that and see if someone's put a video on there or something like that. Kelly Kim likes the new camera changes. Oh yes, dear. It's all here, Kelly Kim. We've got all the equipment. There's one over the side there. Look, it's one over at the back. One over at the back. It's all here, dear. The only thing is the one at the back, you can see my bald spot a bit worse, can you? Although it's not, I don't think it's looking too bad today, to be honest. Call in if you want to. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. As always, boys and girls, don't forget there's a fake news item. It's all fake news. Fake news item within the show as usual, OK? What's the time? Oh, my God, have I done half hour already? It's nearly time for lunch. We must speed up, dear. Must speed up. Aldi. Now, have you ever wondered how quickly those tills in Aldi are so fast, aren't they? They get, we've got an Aldi just down the road here. They get very upset if you start packing your bags at the checkout. Oh, yes. Oh, a woman was dragged out once. I watched it. She was trying to pack her bags and the staff says, what are you doing? She says, I'm packing my bags. You must do it on the shelf. She said, I want to do it here. At which point, five members of the staff dragged the woman out of Aldi into the street and started beating her. Beat them like that. Beat them. Lulling her. Beating. You must pack your bags at the shelf away from the till so they can move you through as rapidly as possible. German efficiency. That's what it's all about, dear. German efficiency, dear. Yes. Well, in the Daily Mail this morning, it claims to get you through the checkout queue 40% quicker than its rivals. I'll go along with that. I think they do. They do very well with that. And it seems there's a good reason. Aldi's till staff are so speedy. A whistleblower claims the chain's workers face the sack if they fail to scan at least 1,000 items an hour. One moment, please. So how many items is that a minute? So it's one. Is that 1,000? Divide by 60? Does that work? I think so. Divide by 60. So they have to... Blimey. They have to scan 16 items a minute to get to that. 1,000 items an hour, this bloke says. Former deputy manager Andre Iguodala and those who miss the target says those who miss the target, which equates to an item every 3.5 seconds, are hauled into performance reviews with managers and can be let go if it happens 3 times or beaten. Beat them. Beat them. It's the only way. You can't be talking to people about things. They have to be beaten into submission. I keep telling you that, lovey. He said some customers are angry at not having enough time to bag their shopping. Mr. Accused bosses of knowing the figure was unrealistic, but said it was used to pressure staff into working at breakneck pace. Well, of course, dear. You've got to have something in there, haven't you, for the customers to come into? Cheap shopping and quick checkouts. That's what we want, dear. Well, it's not what I want. I don't go in there very often. I do go into Aldi. It is very, very cheap in Aldi. Really cheap. Customer service, forget that. They ain't got time to talk to you, mate. Not like we were in a Waitrose today. There I was chatting away to Linda. Linda's on the customer services. My other friend wasn't in there today. Now, what's her name? Michelle. Michelle, who does her now. All right. Hello, Michelle. Oh, hello, how are you? She's like that all the time. Oh, nice to see you again. What are you doing in here today? There's some horrible people in here today. She's a bit like that, Michelle. We love Michelle. Love Michelle, dead to bits. And, of course, the bloke who does the security. Always have a little bit of a chat with him. Although, when you're talking to him, he don't really look at you. You can see him looking at other people. checking for burglars and thieves who must be taken outside and beaten in front of everyone. Beat them, yes. The story goes, we all got performance reviews and deputy managers will get told if they were not keeping up. If you don't hit these targets, you are shown your actual speed and have a performance review meeting with managing staff. If this happens three times, you can be go. Well, do it faster then. Do it faster then. You know the rules, mate. Don't be right into the Daily Mail. We're not interested. You know the rules. You were taken on to scan 1,000 items a time, according to yourself here. So if you can't do it, you'll have to go. And that's all there is to it, lovey. Dear me, can't you keep up? Blimey. I set myself a target of saying 5,000 words every 15 minutes. And I think I keep up with that, don't you, lovey? I think I do keep up with the 5,000 words. Yes, indeed. One more story today in this morning's Super Sore Away Sun. Oh, yes. The traditional glass ketchup bottle is much more pleasing to the eye than the squeezy variety. Oh, I go along with that. Don't you like the Heinz ketchup bottle? The glass one. Isn't it nice? It is a thing of art, isn't it? It's absolutely a thing of art, I think. Really is. Anyway, and so much better than those nasty little plastic things. Although it's easier to get out of the plastic things, you just give it a little squeeze. Give it a little squeeze. Some things I think taste better in glass and cans, like Coca-Cola. You have a bottle of Coca-Cola, cold. Don't you think it tastes better than the plastic one? I do. There's something different about drinking Coca-Cola from a plastic bottle. Other than, number one, a bottle, very nice. And number two, a tin, which is also quite nice. The tins are Coke, the bottles are nice, nice. Plastic bottles, no, not nice. Why is that? Does it actually change the taste? Or what's all that about? I can't put my finger on why it tastes so different from a plastic bottle than either a tin or a bottle. Bottle. Did I say bottom? Bottle. That's enough about bottoms today. It goes on, as all ketchup lovers know, getting the tasty tomato sauce out of the glass bottle can be a complete nightmare. Oh, you know how it is with the knife in it. Oh, come on. Oh, it's not. Oh, half the bottle's gone on your chips. I do put a lot of tomato sauce on chips, I have to admit. All these years, if you're banging the bottom. Oh, my God, can you hear that? There's a helicopter coming over now. Oh, that'd be me. Yeah, just put the wages. Can you leave them downstairs? Hello. It's only the army. Hello, boys. All right. They often pop round, the army boys in their little helicopter. They land in my garden. I've got a helicopter pad in my garden. And often, you know, members of the armed forces do pop in for tea. Just leave that old gun outside, dear. We're not having arms in here. Thank you very much. Anyway, back to this. Heinz have been helpfully placed the number at the right spot. But if you're banging the bottom, you're doing it all wrong. Now, have you been doing that? Has someone been banging your bottom? Well, you're doing it all wrong, dear. Every bottle has the number 57 etched into its glass neck, originating from the famous 57 varieties or slogan of the brand. But apparently, this is not just pretty packaging. In fact, it has an amazing function of its own, as a sweet spot to smack if you want to speed the flow. Well, we didn't know this. Why didn't some idiot tell us this? How are we supposed to know these things? It's a little bit like these. I bought these today. Where are they gone? Oh, what did I do with those? I thought I bought some. I bought these. Is it on there? There it is. I bought these today in Waitrose, right? And I'm trying to work out. I've never had these before. Antibacterial surface wipes. And I'm like, well, there must be somewhere. And I had to ask a lady who was walking by, how do you get these out? Oh, they've got a little plastic thing on here. And here it is. Here it, look, it's got a little plastic thing. And they come out. I haven't bought these ones before. Now, I have bought others before, but this one, you can't actually see the thing on there. And I'm going, it's a little bit like opening, you know, sellotape. That's that's gone round and he can't get the blooming topper. And it was just like that. And I had trouble getting him up. I've got it up in the end with assistance from some woman. How are you supposed to know? No one tells you. Well, it's the same with these. To get the best results, you should turn your ketchup bottle at an angle and hit it exactly at the point of the 57 to get the maximum stream. Did you know that? Of course you didn't. So you don't hit the bottom, you hit it on the side where the number 57 is. Try it at home today on your chips. Yum, yum, yum. Yeah, try it on your chips today and see how that goes. All right. Very, very strange and mysterious, dear. Strange and mysterious. All right. Let's do today's birthdays. And then I must go down and have my dinner because it's getting a little bit late now. Kelly Kim says, for my linen jacket, I needed a steamer. Well, as I say, Kelly Kim, it's here. Look. Hang on a minute. It's here, Kelly Kim. I took it to Mrs. Patel, who works at the... I think she owns the dry cleaners. And I asked her to do that, and it came back not much difference to what it gave me. A particular problem is this here. Look, do you see? Can you see where the holes, right? So the edge just keeps turning inwards. And I don't know how to do this. And the same with the buttons. Can you see the buttons? Look, they keep turning inwards there. And I don't know why that's happening. Can you use an iron on these? Shall I try an iron? I don't know why that is, and I love this jacket. And it's very, very summery. Very, very summery and light and airy. A little bit like yourself, my love. A little bit like yourself. All right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Happy birthday today to the lovely Simon Marcus Gelling. Happy birthday, Simon. He's been in and out of hospital recently, haven't he? I hope you're doing all right. Very good friend of mine, Simon. And we nearly broke... Simon once came up to me with... to Leeds with me. And on the way back, we nearly run out of petrol. I mean, we must have been so close to running out of petrol. The fuel light, this is about 20 years ago, the fuel light had been on for ages. I mean ages. So happy birthday today to Simon. Susan Greer today is 35 years old. Happy birthday, Susan Greer. Madam Aeries is 60 today. Oh, come on, 60, dear. A little bit more than that, aren't you, lovey? 60. Madam Aeries is 60 today. Happy birthday, Madam Aeries. And Jacqueline. Jackie Veens? Is that you, Jackie? Aha! It's got to be Jackie Veens. Hang on a minute. Let me just check. One moment, please. Is it you? It is. Ha ha! Jackie Veens, who I used to work with at British Telecom. She was a very, very, very good friend of mine, Jackie Veens, I've got to say to you. And we had some laughs at British Telecom when we worked on directory inquiries. And I was there for about 5 years. It's got to be one of the most boring jobs in the world, looking up phone numbers for people that are too lazy to look them up themselves. But it was a job, and British Telecom, to work for British Telecom is very good. You know, they really looked after us at the time. And at that time, of course, directory inquiries was free. You just rung. We worked at one. There were two directory inquiries in London. There was 192 if you wanted a phone number for outside London. And there was 142. This is the one we worked on. 142 where you wanted a phone number in London. And the most asked for phone number was Victoria Coach Station. I must have given it out 20, 30, 40 times a day. 0207, it's not this number now, I don't think. 0207300202. That was the number. I remember that. Followed closely by Victoria Railway Station. 020-01-928-5100. I think that was it. 928-510. I'll never forget those phone numbers. And Jackie and I, we got on so well. We really did. And we had another friend, Jean Highland, who passed away some years ago now. I did go to her funeral and she was lovely as well. But yeah, happy birthday, Jackie. Lovely to see ya. See your little name pop up there. Jackie, it's her birthday today. Let's sing the song, boys and girls. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Simon, Susan, Madam Aeries and Jaqueline. Happy birthday to you. All right? Enjoy your birthdays, boys and girls. Enjoy those birthdays. Can we just pop back to a couple of messages from yesterday's show, boys and girls? And they are from, let's have a look, Graham Lang. Graham. Now, Manilow ladies, you're not going to like this. Neither do I. Graham has dissed Barry. Sort of. He says, anyone who has so many facelifts like Barry has got to be gay. How rude are you? How rude, dear. I used to know a friend who has so many facelifts, his belly button was then on his chin. You mustn't talk about Jeremy Corbyn like that, lovey. You really mustn't, darling. Is it true that Jeremy Corbyn, that beard is to hide all the facelifts he's had? He must have had a very bad surgeon, that's all I can say. Thank you, Graham. Hello to Stacey White, who's in who's in the USA. And Stacey says, Barry Manilow's orientation is no surprise here in the US. It's been accepted for a long time. Maybe he wasn't aware people knew. Great entertainer also. So thank you for Stacey White. Stacey White was on a programme on BBC Three some years ago. Now, what was it? Oh, yeah, I remember now. It was taking in English, young, older English teenagers who were a bit, how would you put it, rowdy, were always getting into trouble and didn't appreciate things going on around them. And Stacey took a couple of those in and knocked them into shape, didn't you, Stacey? Well done, sir. Andrew also says, I always assumed Barry Manilow was gay. I think so, Andrew. Eloise says, on the subject of his album release, because he's got an album coming out soon, and I did say, and there's a couple of people that messaged me privately, actually, I won't say who they were. They did say, has he come out as gay to create lots of interest and then release an album? And Eloise actually says, nothing to do with the album release. The People interview was done a year ago, just released this week. Barry and Gary had no say on when it would be published. So thank you for correcting me there, Eloise. We always like a bit of correction, Eloise. Always like some correction. There we are. Okay, so what was today's fake news item, boys and girls? Oh, I didn't have the button pushed for that. Sorry, you didn't hear the music properly. Just me singing, didn't you? That was disappointing, wasn't it, lovey? Eh? Just me singing. Hang on a minute. Let's just take that phone number off there. Right, so today's fake news item, boys and girls.
We are fighting the fake news. It's fake, phony, fake. A few days ago, I called the fake news the enemy of the people.
Enemy.
And they
enemy.
Are. They are the enemy of the people. They're very dishonest people that I called the fake news
dishonest.
The enemy of the people.
Fake
the
news.
Fake news.
Fake news.
And now I'm saying, oh, no, this is no good. But
you are fake news.
But I am only against the fake news media or press. Fake. Fake.
All fake, boys and girls. It's all fake news. And today's fake news was the Coca-Cola Helium story. There will be no Coca-Cola Helium. And, you know, I'm really disappointed because that could be quite fun, wouldn't it? Coca-Cola with Helium. I could do the whole show in a high-pitched voice. You would even think I was gay once I did a show like that, wouldn't you? Ah, well, that's it for the show today, boys and girls. It's Friday night, so Friday night means it's karaoke tonight, boys and girls. And the karaoke, if you want to come along, is at... Oh, I haven't told you the... I didn't tell you my disaster in the kitchen on Tuesday, did I? I'll save it. There you are. I'm hooking you in now. Hooking you in with another story, aren't I? Yes, I'll save that for the next show, OK? Tonight, it's Friday night, so I'll be hosting karaoke at Central Station in King's Cross. Wharfdale Road in King's Cross starts at 8:30 and finishes at midnight. You need to get your songs in by about 10:30. We get very, very busy there. All right, so karaoke tonight at Central Station Bar, Wharfdale Road, every Friday from 8:30 right the way through till midnight. Thank you very much for watching the show today, boys and girls. And thank you, those of you also that shared the show on your wall. If you want to comment after the show is finished, that's fine. Just put your comment underneath there and I'll read it out on the next show. Enjoy your Friday. It's beautiful out there. Time for my lunch and a little bit of gardening. See you soon. Bye-bye now.